When I was a kid, so this is an interesting story, because when I was a kid, I had an erroneous view of what mathematics is. I thought that mathematics is what I was doing in school, which was basically doing, I don't know, 20, 50 computational problems, sitting down and just solving one problem after the next one. And while I enjoyed some of that, it's certainly not what mathematics is. And I've now realized as a mathematician, mathematics is a much broader subject that involves problem solving, and it involves developing new ideas, new ways of finding insights into a problem, sometimes finding ways to connect two seemingly completely different ideas and being able to link them. Mathematics is much more about using logic to solve problems. And the beauty of it for me is that it can be enjoyed from many different lenses. I like to look at the mathematics behind games, the mathematics in sports, and the mathematics in a couple of areas called abstract algebra and combinatorics. Other people like to look at mathematics and arts, and there's a rich history there. Statistics, mathematics related to social justice, mathematics related to medicine, mathematics and music is a popular one. So there are many, many ways in which we can look at subjects and do it with a mathematical lens. And there are other people that just do mathematics for the love of it, because it's beautiful and interesting and artistic, and we get challenges and we get to solve problems doing that. So my message to everyone out there, whether you like math or not, is I encourage you to find something that you like and try to look at it with a mathematical lens. At first, it might seem difficult because you might not know how to do that, but perhaps with help and guidance from someone, you might end up wanting to become a mathematician too, or at the very least, you might end up having a greater appreciation for what mathematics is.
It's a real treat for me to get to share with you what math means to me and what I get out of being a career mathematician. Actually, when I think about it, for me, mathematics is many things. It's my creative outlet. Yes, math fosters creativity because creativity is deeply rooted and embedded in problem solving. I have to be creative as I think of new ways to define and solve problems that I'm interested in. Math is also the way that I contribute to finding better ways to treat one of the world's deadliest diseases. Believe it or not, math can be good medicine in the fight against cancer. I know this because I'm an applied mathematician and mathematical oncologist. That just means a person who uses mathematics and scientific computing to enhance the current understanding of how tumors initially form, how they spread, and how best to treat them. My day job is developing mathematical equations that describe cancer growth with an eye towards addressing critical challenges associated with new treatment strategies, including determining which drugs are best for people with a particular kind of cancer. These models can suggest optimal ways to deliver a single drug or combinations of drugs to patients that are suffering from this disease. It's actually an exciting time to work at the interface of mathematics and cancer biology. The continued use of team-based, multidisciplinary approaches that include math are accelerating scientific progress towards more effective treatments and potentially saving lives. That's why math is so very important to me.
Yeah, when I think about mathematics, I think about the power to see the hidden patterns that underlie everything that we see and the things that are going on in the world. So in some ways, math is the power to see the unseen. So it can help you, for instance, understand what's going on when a wave crashes onto the beach, when a virus spreads across the world, some of the math that's going on behind the wonderful technological innovations that we all use every day. And in some ways, math, it comes across as being magical, right? When you don't see what's going on underneath the things that you do, it can seem like magic. I mean, it seems like magic when I pull out my smartphone and I can watch a TV show, right? But what's, I think, even more amazing and maybe even more magical is when you're able to understand what's going on behind the scenes. And that's part of the wonder. That's part of the beauty, the mystery that's being uncovered. It's part of the attraction of doing mathematics, is being able to understand. And so that's what I hope for everyone. I hope everybody has the opportunity to experience that kind of wonder and that kind of appreciation for the hidden patterns of the world, and how our minds, when harnessed in good ways, can help us in flourishing by understanding and seeing these things.
The way I became interested in math was really through high school, through my high school teacher, Jaime Escalante, from who the movie Standing Deliver was created because of the work that he did with inner city students and really getting them to do calculus when no one really believed in them. So one of the things that I think that was very powerful and that I was very lucky to have is him as a teacher, but also his motivation and the inspiration that he transferred to me in terms of math. He really believed in me. So he believed that I would go all the way in to college. When I met him, I could think of it as that I was gonna become a cashier. That was the pinnacle of my goals, to be a cashier, because my parents were janitors and I didn't want that kind of job. So I thought, well, the best I could aspire was to be a store cashier, plus it deals with numbers. But with him, I realized that I could do more than that. And after having him, actually, I thought I was gonna be an engineer. And then I went to Wellesley College and I realized that maybe that was not the best path for me. And but I love math, so I stayed with math and I became a math and economics major at Wellesley College. And then from there, I went to Cornell for my master's and PhD in applied mathematics. And what really inspires me to keep on going and to really, and the passion that I have for mathematics comes from the applications and the fact that math is in everything. It's really the foundation of everything. And it really allows us to gain a solid understanding of how different things work and even identify certain properties that we haven't been able to identify with a lot of years of research in the lab or in field work. With mathematics, we're able to do it in a cost-efficient way, but also in a very quick way by using computer science and simulations.
I've always been drawn to the logical nature of mathematics. I found comfort even when I was a small child in pattern finding. When I explained mathematics to others, I felt like I was letting them in on a special secret that would make investigating mathematics as fun for them as it was for me. I remember when I was in sixth grade and I explained to my brother how to solve an algebraic equation for a variable. And he wondered why his teacher couldn't explain it as clearly as I could. And I knew right then what my future career was going to be. I went to graduate school to earn my PhD in mathematics so that I could teach in college. But it was there that I rediscovered my love of mathematics. When you're in high school and college and graduate school, you study mathematics out of textbooks. And that math has already been discovered. It's been analyzed and synthesized and distilled down into a textbook. But when you are finally at the frontiers of mathematical understanding, it's an amazing feeling. At the time I was in graduate school, my advisor, Don Sari, was doing research in voting theory, the mathematics behind tallying elections. And mathematicians before had discovered interesting little puzzles, odd little results that had come out of elections, but Don was looking to put together a theory that explained all these results and much more. Every time we discovered a little mathematical piece of the puzzle and put it into place, we were stretching the boundaries of mathematical knowledge just a little bit further. He suggested to me there might be connections between voting theory and statistics. So I was off on an adventure for 2 years where I was studying statistics, looking for connections between the two fields, and publishing what I discovered so that I could
give ideas to others of what they could build on in mathematics. I wish everyone could experience this exhilaration of the discovery of some new mathematical ideas. Wouldn't it be great if secondary school students thought of this as what mathematics was like, instead of learning mathematics out of a textbook, that it's the thrill of discovery? At this point in my career, I'm mostly teaching undergraduates mathematics, and I hope that they will pass on this joy of mathematical discovery to the next generation. This past year, I worked with a group of undergraduates who went into our local middle school and started a math circle. A math circle is a place where students can go and get introduced to a topic and get an interesting question that they can begin looking for their own patterns and their own little mathematical discoveries. The mathematics they discover might not be new to the world, but it's new to them, and they own it and experience the joy of discovery. And after all, that's what mathematics is all about.